Welcome back, everybody. I hope you're having a wonderful day here in Long Beach. It's a beautiful day here, or wherever you're joining us from this morning. You know, as always, there's a lot happening in the world of aviation, so right now we're going to catch up on some of the latest news. You know, with the economy continuing to struggle, it's no surprise that third quarter shipments of general aviation aircraft were down this year. But there are signs of a brighter future. The General Aviation Manufacturers Association reported that GA shipments fell 14.5% in the first 9 months of 2010. Now, billings for the same period totaled $13.5 billion. Now, that number was down 2.5%. Well, Gamma President and CEO Pete Bunce said he is nevertheless encouraged by recent sales announcements and by a more positive outlook overall. We also noted that general aviation manufacturers are spending more on research and development for new products. That's good news for us as pilots. Well, Pete Bunce will join AOPA President Craig Fuller here on the AOPA live stage on Saturday, so be sure and tune in for that. It'll be a great conversation about the future of general aviation. We know after almost 70 years in the cold waters of Lake Michigan, a rare bout F4U Corsair has been recovered. The plane was sitting in 240 feet of water, where it came to rest after crashing during an air carrier landing on the USS Wolverine. Now, pilot Carl H. Johnson survived that crash, but was later killed in the Pacific while flying from the USS Enterprise. Well, it took a team of several hundred people to recover the plane, which emerged from the deep covered in seaweed and mussels. Well, experts say the plane would have completely disintegrated in another 10 years. Well, the Navy still owns the airplane and plans to restore it for display at the National Naval Aviation Museum in Pensacola, Florida. Well, Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University will study how pilots make decisions in a low-oxygen environment with the help of a new Mentor Advanced Aircraft Training device from Frasca. Now, the device replicates the cockpit of a Cessna 172, complete with a Garmin G1000 panel. But it adds sophisticated data recording equipment to measure pilot performance. Imagine that. Researchers at the university will use it to see how well or how poorly pilots perform at high altitudes, where reduced levels of oxygen can affect behavior. I always get a headache at high altitude and can't think too clearly with hypoxia. Well, the research will take place at the university's high altitude lab in Daytona Beach, Florida. Now, the lab, the first of its kind, opened in 2009 to teach pilots how to recognize and recover from the damaging effects of low blood oxygen levels, as I said, called hypoxia. Well, here's some good news. Retired U.S. Airways Captain Sully Sullenberger will receive the prestigious Neil Armstrong Medal of Excellence from Purdue University on Friday. Well, as we all remember, Captain Sully became a household name after he successfully landed an airliner on the Hudson River. Amazing. He made the emergency landing after bird strike shut down both of his engines on January 15, 2009. You know, he is only the second person to receive the Armstrong Medal, which is awarded at the discretion of the Purdue Board of Trustees. And this goes to an individual who embodies the pioneer spirit, determination, and dedication that have distinguished former astronauts Neil Armstrong's career. So both Armstrong and Sullenberger actually are graduates of Purdue University. And Armstrong will personally present that award that carries his name. Well, one of the great names in aircraft design says he will retire next spring. Burt Rutan, you're going to retire on us, huh? All right. You know, he's the founder of Scaled Composites, the designer of the first passenger spaceship. He says he's going to retire in April after more than 36 years in aircraft design and development. Now, before starting the Rutan Aircraft Factory in 1974, he was a flight test engineer for the U.S. Air Force. And in 2004, he won the $10 million X Prize for designing and building Spaceship One. Woo-hoo! And you remember Voyager, too, that flew around the world. His brother Dick and Gina Yeager flew it around the world. Well, a second-generation spaceship that will take tourists into low Earth orbit is now in development. I'm sure, of course, we've all heard about that. And you can learn more about that during tomorrow morning's keynote address right here on AOPA Live, when one of our featured speakers will be Stephen Attenborough of Virgin Galactic airways. How very, very exciting. A lot going on here for you folks in Long Beach.